Hello, this is Paolo Ciccone, and today I'd like to show you a new feature of Reality 4.3. This is very exciting for me. I think that when you'll see it, you'll ask yourself, how did you survive before this? Well, maybe it's a bit of an exaggeration, but this is really a useful way of changing your workflow when editing materials in Reality. Now, let me just say up front, I'm going to use for a brief moment DAZ Studio. Poser users, if you're watching this, please keep watching it, because sometimes I use Studio, sometimes I use Poser. I can't make it the same video twice. So next time I'll use Poser. It's really not an issue here, because most of the work, the vast majority of what we're going to see, will be done in Reality. And Reality is exactly the same whether you're using Poser or Studio. So let's begin. Per texture, copy and paste. How does it work? Well, let's think that for a second we have a scene with two figures in it, and I have a texture, actually I have a material where there is no texture for the bump map. This can happen for a variety of reasons. So let's say that I want to create a new texture and I'm going to use the distorted noise or the clouds. So let's say I use the clouds texture, okay? And I'm going to create basically a procedural bump map for this material. Now I'm going to change this to use the noise size of 0.3, a noise depth of 3, and a brightness 1.2. And turn the scale down to 20%, and let's see the result. Okay, so this is a possible texture. Let's increase the contrast to 1.8, just to put some numbers in here to change. Okay, this actually could be a bump map. So let's say that I like it. I think that this is working very well for my figure. So now I would have, in the past, with the previous versions of Reality, I would have to repeat the same thing, or I could use the sync option. And that is still valid, but here there is another more flexible option. I can go here to my skin torso where I created my texture, and if I click on the gear menu, I see a handy copy menu. And I click on it, as usual. The texture is copied. There's no message that is shown, but it is now in memory. So now I can go to any other material. I go here to skin leg, and I click on the gear menu for the bump map, and I select paste. Here it is. So now we have our clouds, the noise size is 0.03, noise depth has been changed, the brightness has been changed, the contrast, the scale, everything is looking exactly the same. Great. So we can move it forward one more step. I can just select all the skin materials here. And you know, the skin leg I don't need, and skin torso I don't need, because I already created the textures for these. You know, I can go, I have all the skin materials here, and then click on the bump map gear menu and select paste. And now all the materials had received the clouds texture pasted. Same parameters. So per texture, copy and paste works across materials, and it works with multi-edit. But that's not all. Whenever you see a texture preview, this is called a texture preview here, the part that says bump map, clouds, so there is the gray circle, the name of the texture here, the preview here, and the gear menu. All this, you know, this little rectangle area, it's called a texture preview. So whenever you see a texture preview, you will have the copy and paste option, and you can do the same, you can perform the same operation there. So let's see another example in action. Let's say that in the face material, so here we have, let me reorder by name of the material. And here we have the skin face. Now, if I look in the skin face, I see that I have a mixed material for the diffuse channel. And a mixed texture. A mixed texture basically takes two textures and allows us to mix them together, either with a fixed amount or through another texture. If you haven't used this before, this is going to be very interesting. So here we have the texture A, which is just the base map, the face map, okay? And we have a second texture, texture B, which is a color. A solid color is still a texture, okay? And in the mixed amount, I can use any number between 0 and 1. 0 will show just texture A, and 1 will just show texture B. Any number in between will mix them. So for example, if I use 0.3, I will have 70% of texture A and 30% of texture B. So we see the base texture, the map, the image map, but with definitely a very red tint. So let's go to 0. You see how it is? Just the base texture A. And if I go 0.3, it gives a very reddish hue. Now, conversely, if I say 0.7, I will have 70% of the B texture and 30% of the A texture. Okay, well, this is okay, but it's not terribly useful. So let's say again that I decide to create a texture from scratch on my own, and I'll use the, so let me just move this in a way that stays in the frame. Okay, and I'm gonna use the distorted noise texture. And this texture, you can see now, it creates these specks, because basically on one part of the texture we have black and the other we have white, and we interpolate values of gray between the two. Wherever it's black, it's the equivalent of the zero value we had in the mix, and whenever it is pure white, that is the one value. So whenever it's 0, it will show the base texture, texture A, and when it's white, it will show texture B. If there is a value in between, it will mix it. And here it is, how it is represented. So let's say I'm gonna go here. Oh, by the way, when I use this texture, this value is completely ignored. So doesn't matter what's in here. Let's say I'm editing this texture and I'll change the distortion amount to, let's say 4, the noise size to 0.05, the brightness to 1.3, the contrast to 1.1. And the scale, we're gonna go again around 23%. Okay. Too much? It seems a little too subtle, so let's go to 50%. Let's see, contrast. Maybe we have to lower the contrast. Let's see. All good tests that we can do. I'll try contrast at 2. And I think we are seeing just the noise sides might be a little too small. Here it is. So now we have this kind of a weird effect on the face. Could be a disease. No, that's perfect. That's what I wanted. Takes a little bit of trial and error. I finally found the right effect. I want to apply the same effect, not to Victoria, but to this other figure. How do I do that? we can do it with a copy and paste. I click on the distort the noise and I copy the texture. Why am I doing this? Because I already have prepared the face of the other figure to have something similar, like this kind of mix, but this time with blue instead of red. And now I can go here in a sub-texture and paste it. And here is the result. Isn't that great? So now we can do copy and paste of a single texture if I want. So all the other methods we had before, the multi-edit and sync, they're still available. But for something that is so specific, when you want to change one single texture, you want to copy, you want to move it around, you can absolutely do that with pair texture, copy and paste. And it works at this level with the material, or at the subtexture level, it works in multi-edit, and it works across materials and across objects. So you can copy and paste on any other object that you have in the scene. So this is it. This is the new feature, and it's only one of the many features of Reality 4.3. But I hope you'll enjoy it, and thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.